Hi to all. In this video, we'll be marking 7th standard term 1 history unit 1 sources of medieval India. We shall start with the first Roman number. Choose the correct answer. First question, dash are the writings engraved on solid surfaces such as rocks, stones, temple walls and metals. Answer is D, inscriptions. Second one, dash was the land gifted to temples. Answer is D, Devadana. Third one, dash period was known as the period of devotional literature. A, Chola. Question number 4, dash provides information about the first Sultan of Delhi. Answer is A, Aini Akbari. Fifth question, dash, an Arab born Morocco scholar, travelled from Morocco to India. Answer is D, Ibn Battuta. Fill in the blanks. Dash, first one, dash inscriptions provide details about administration in a Brahmadeya village, Uttiramerur. Answer is Uttiramerur. Second one, dash had stamped the figure of goddess Lakshmi on his gold coins and had his name inscribed on it. Answer is Mohammed Ghori. 3.6 grains of silver amounted to a jital, J-I-T-A-L. Fourth one, dash was patronized by Sultan Nasiruddin Muhammad of slave dynasty. Answer is Minhaj us Siraj. Spelling is M-I-N-H-A-J hyphen then U-S hyphen S-I-R-A-J. Fifth question, an Italian traveler dash visited Vijayanagar Empire in 1420. Answer is Niccolo Conti. Niccolo Conti. Match the following. All the matches are about the temples built in India and their locations. Khajuraho, it's found in Madhya Pradesh. Konark in Odisha. Dilwara, Rajasthan. Virupaksha, Hampi. Say true or false. First Roman number, Palli Chandam was the land donated to Jaina institution, that is to the Jains, institutions run by the Jains. True. Second one, the composition of metal coins gives us information on the political condition of the empire. That is also true. It explains how prosperous the empire was. Third one, the high cost of copper made palm leaf and paper cheaper alternatives for recording royal orders and events in royal court. It is true. Next one, Domingo Pais, a Portuguese traveler, visited the Chola Empire in 1522. It is false. He visited Vijayanagar Empire. Match the statement with the reason and tick the appropriate answer. Here we have the assertion and reasoning. The assertion and reasoning is a statement given and we have a reason also for that statement. The first statement here is Mohammed Ghori's gold coins carried the figure of goddess Lakshmi. The reason is the Turkish invader was liberal in his religious outlook. Answer is R is the correct explanation for A. Find out the wrong pair. Here we have two sides, one with the literature or the books written by the different people here. And the wrong one paired here is Ibn Battuta. Tahik-e-Hind, that is not the book written by Ibn Battuta. Find out the odd one. Inscriptions travelogues, monuments and coins. Here travelogues is the odd one because all the other three belong to the primary source of inscriptions, primary source of history. Answer the following in one or two questions. Who compiled Nalaira Divya Prabandham? Answer is Nada Muni. Second question, what does the word tusk, T-U-Z-K, tusk mean? It means autobiography. Name Jahangir's memoir. Tusk-e-Jahangiri. Name the two different types of sources for the study of history. The answer is in page number 102. You can see the box here, classification of sources. The two sources are primary sources and secondary sources. Next question is, list out the important mosques and forts constructed during the medieval times, page number 104. Here we have Quwat-ul-Islam Masjid, Moth-e-Masjid, Jama Masjid, Fatehpur Sikri Dargah, all in and around Delhi, and Charminar in Hyderabad are the important mosques belonging to the medieval time. The forts that belong to the same medieval period is the Agra Fort, Chittur Fort, Gwalior Fort and Delhi Red Fort, and also the forts of Dauladabad and Feroz Shah Kotla in Delhi. Next, sixth question, mention the important foreign travelers who visited India during the medieval period. The answer is in page number 106. Here I have the travelers and travelogues. Under the heading I have marked you the first few important persons, Marco Polo and then Al-Biruni and Ibn Battuta. Roman, we are marking history first lesson for 7th standard in term 1, and we shall meet again in the next video. Thank you all.